In the previous video, we have seen that how we can create a repository on Beanstalk and push our code. Now, let's go ahead and create one environment server. So just go to the repositories, click on your repository and go to the deployments. Now just click on this create environment and server. Give it a name of your choice. I'm going to give it AWS. Test deployment. The process will be automatic and the branch will be master. Click on add environment. The protocol will be SFTP, that is SSH file transfer protocol. Go on to the next step. Now create a server. Name it as AWS test server. The host will be the IP address of the EC2 instance. This, copy it and paste it here. Remote path will be the directory which we have created in that EC2 instance in the previous video. That was project/api.aws-test.com. The username for all the Ubuntu instances remains Ubuntu only. And we are going to authenticate using SSH key that we have added in the authorized key file. So just go to the next step. Keep the defaults. Go to the next step. Deploy. Just review your settings and start the deployment. See the transfer logs. So our code base was very small, so it just finished in the fraction of a seconds, and the message is displayed that deployment has successfully finished. Now if we SSH into the EC2 terminal, EC2 instance, we can see that our code was successfully deployed in that directory. That is api.aws-test.com. So just quickly navigate into it. project/api.aws-test.com. Now we quickly ls into it, we can see that our code is here. So it was deployed by Beanstalk deployment server that we have just created. Now just quickly npm install into it. So our node modules is in place. Now we are going to run this project. Now in the very first video I have talked about PM2. Now we are going to use PM2 to run this project. So quickly install that, npm install PM2 -g, that is we are going to install it globally. Just wait for a few seconds. So it's installed successfully. Now to run this project, we are going to type the command PM2 app.js. Basically it's pm2 start. app.js. So you can see that our app is online. To check the logs, we can type the command pm2 logs. And you can see that our app is listening on port 3000. Now if we quickly navigate to this IP address and the port 3000, you can see that our app is live. Now we have created one test route, so if we quickly navigate to it, you can see that it is returned as it is. So now our app is up and running on the server. Now in the next lecture we are going to see how we can remove this port 3000. So from now onwards, we are going to study the concept of load balancing and target groups. Thank you.